Why is the same file a different size in different places? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question I got some time ago. When backing up online, my pictures take up around 65 gigabytes, but 88 gigabytes are reported on my computer. Why? You know, this is something, honestly, that's confused computer users for many years. The same file can actually show up as taking a different amount of space, depending on where you look and the characteristics of different disk drives. Copy that file online and things get even more confusing. I don't think I've ever seen this to be anything to worry about. Regardless of the differences, your file is still your file, regardless of where it's stored. All right, let's talk about size versus size. I'm going to use a one-byte file as my example. You can see here in Windows Command Prompt, I have one-byte file, .txt. And you can tell it's exactly 1 byte in length. There's the length for the file. There's the sum total of lengths of all the files, 1 bytes. I use Command Prompt because it clearly shows that the file size is exactly 1 byte. Unlike Windows File Explorer, we'll fire that up and we'll see that it says 1 byte file.txt takes up 1 kilobyte. How is that even possible? Which is it, 1 byte or over 1,000? Well, here's the thing. In a way, it's both. And to understand why that is, we actually need to look at how disk space is allocated. Data on hard disks is stored in sectors of either 512 or 4,096 bytes at a time. This is a physical organization that maximizes the amount of data you can store on the media while providing the ability to recover from errors, access data randomly as needed, and do all of that quickly. File systems, or more accurately, file storage systems, they keep track of all the information about files that are stored on a disk, including in which sectors the data is stored. Rather than track one sector at a time, however, most file systems group multiple sectors together in what are called clusters. Clusters are simply groups of 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, or more adjacent sectors. A file system then tracks the location of a file's data by keeping a list of the clusters that have been assigned to it. If you run check disk with no parameters, it'll display the cluster size used on the drive. In fact, let's do that. If I run check disk, which I'm doing here in an administrative command prompt, it's going to go through, it's checking, it's making sure that things are okay. However, when it's done, at the end, it's going to tell us what it's going to call an allocation unit. That's a cluster. And there we are. 4,096 bytes in each allocation unit. That means either it's a collection of 8 512-byte sectors, or it's a single 4,096-byte sector. In either case, that's the cluster size. Okay? Conceptually, when I created my 1-byte file, the file system had to do a few things. It, of course, created an entry in its table of files, or the directory listing as it's more commonly known. It allocated a cluster on the hard disk to store the file, and it wrote the data to disk. That file was given an entire cluster, 4,096 bytes of disk space, even though the file is only 1 byte in length. A 1-byte file takes up 4 kilobytes of space because that's how disk space is allocated, one cluster at a time. Should that file grow to, say, 4,097 bytes in size, then it'll need an additional cluster. And the 4,097-byte file will then actually take up 8,192 bytes of disk space. Depending on where you're looking, either number might get reported. But wait, File Explorer showed 1 kilobyte, not 4 kilobytes. Well, I said a moment ago, it's conceptually, and it's true for most files of any reasonable size. However, In our case, our one-byte file showed an exception to the process. It's not quite as I described. A file system tracks a lot more than just your file's data. It also records its name, the list of clusters, timestamps, attributes, permissions, and more depending on the file system that you happen to use. All of that metadata, or data about your data, takes up disk space in the file's directory listing. Now, in the NTFS file system directory listing, space within the directory is allocated one chunk at a time. Regardless of the actual amount of metadata, the space it's given grows 1,024 bytes at a time. Here's an optimization that happens. If the file is small enough, and there's enough space in the directory listing itself to also hold the file's data, in addition to whatever other information about the file, it's placed there instead of being allocated any clusters at all. In a sense, the file takes up no additional space on disk beyond its directory listing. When that happens, Windows File Explorer lists the size as 1 kilobyte, the size of the directory listing, rather than the size of the 0 clusters that were allocated to it. All right, everything's the same online, except it's different. It's the same in the sense that cloud storage services are using hard disks just like you and I do. Those hard disks are formatted with file systems, and those file systems allocate space in various ways that probably behave much like I've described. It's a good bet that Microsoft OneDrive uses NTFS formatted hard drives to hold your files. It's all different in the sense that none of it matters. Since the hard disks are hidden from you completely, all OneDrive and other cloud storage providers show you are your files and their actual file sizes. While it's important for you to know how much space your files are consuming on the hard disk on your machine, that information is completely irrelevant for the things you store online. It could even change as cloud storage providers transparently update their infrastructure, possibly moving your data from hard disks formatted one way to hard disks formatted some other way. The result of all this: the pictures you have on your hard disk that take up 88 gigabytes of space on your disk might actually only be 65 gigabytes worth of actual data. Chalk up the difference to file system overhead and that disk space is allocated in increments of clusters. Bottom line is that when you see two different numbers for the size of your file, don't panic. Instead, realize that there are two different sizes associated with every file on your hard disk: the size of the actual file's data and the amount of space that the file takes up on disk. It's simply that the two can be different. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/93651. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.